on Sunday. And I know you remember this story because we have done this so many times, but really, you know, now they used to say it's party time, you know? This is what this is, a big celebration. It's party time because we're celebrating when Jesus arrived into Jerusalem to be the king. He's our king, isn't he? And this was his open time that he's let them know, I am your king. So he was arriving in Jerusalem. But he didn't come like we would come nowadays. He what? But he did. Didn't he ride an airplane into Jerusalem?
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute. It must have been
a bus.
A bus? A helicopter, maybe. Oh, I know. He came in on a train.
No.
Oh, well, how did he come with me?
On a donkey.
On a donkey. That is so true. He rode into Jerusalem on a donkey. All right. Because you know why he did that? Because he didn't come to be a fancy king. He could have. And he could have really been fancy if he wanted to. Fancier than we could ever be.
That's right.
But he came in humble. He rode on a donkey. That didn't mean he wasn't the king, and still is, does it? That's the way he wanted to do it, to show his humbleness, okay? And he came to be king for what reason? What did he do for us? Huh? Yes, you said it, go ahead. He came as our king, but then he eventually died for our sins, so that we could get forgiveness for our sins. That's why he died, okay? So what he did on Palm Sunday was very important. And we're still celebrating it, aren't we?
Mm-hmm.
And as long as we're alive, we're going to keep on celebrating this beautiful day when he rode into Jerusalem on that donkey. Okay? And you know, the people, that's the way they welcomed him. They had their palms, and a lot of them, and they'd even lay their clothes and palms down on the ground, and they'd wave them at him. That's how they would, like we might have whistles and some fancy streamers and stuff nowadays, but this is what they use, the palm trees, to welcome him in. So we're going to continue to celebrate this magnificent Palm Sunday, and right now we're going to see what the Bible says about Palm Sunday.
Matthew chapter 21, verses 7 through 11 says, and brought the donkey and the colt, and put on them their clothes, and they set him thereon. And a very great multitude spread their garments in the way. Others cut down branches from the trees and strawed them in the way. And the multitudes that went before and that followed cried, saying, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. And when he was come into Jerusalem, all the city was moved, saying, who is this? And the multitude said, this is Jesus, the prophet of Nazareth of Galilee.
Amen.
Now, did we just say that? So do you notice what we just talked about was in the Bible? And that's where you learn all of this. You keep reading your Bible as you grow. If you can't read, get your parents or someone to read to you, because this is where you find all of it. All right? Let's just take a moment now to thank Jesus for being our King, okay? So everybody bow their head. Dear gracious Heavenly Father, repeat after me. Dear gracious Heavenly Father,
dear gracious Heavenly Father,
thank you for sending your Son.
Thank you for sending your Son,
Jesus.
Jesus.
And that he is our King.
And that he is our King.
We want you to know.
We want